This is our 1936 Norton Model 18. It's a 500cc single, cast iron barrel, cast iron head. And these bikes were very sought after. They had beautiful coachwork on them and their painting was superb. Silver paint with black striping and red pinstriping around that. And it was even echoed into the wheels with the black and the red stripe around it. A very, very smart looking motorcycle and the envy of every young boy back in Britain in its day. It had a tank that has an in-dash built into the tank. So in that dash, you had your filler, you have your speedometer, you have the amp meter, and you have your switch for it, all built into this beautiful chrome panel on the gas tank. Also, the arrangement of how the handlebars were laid out was, I won't say unique, it was actually unique to our thinking today, but really in its day they were all laid out very similar. Still had the brake on the right and the clutch on the left, but it had a decompressor down below that. You had two different levers, one for carburetor, one for ignition. So you had a lot of various things to juggle when you were starting and you were riding your bike down the road. Gorgeous 8-inch headlight on it that really made a statement. These manufacturers took a lot of pride into how they built their product. This is the steering damper here, and their Norton logo is emblazoned on it and raised, cast right into it. And not the type of thing you'd see today. They had extra things on them, like a toolbox on the side that you could put your tools in, and it had a lock on it so you could lock it and keep them safe. It also has dampers on the side of the girder front end to give you a little bit better ride in the front end. And your passenger is sitting on the back seat here with their own footrests because the rider is in a single seat position. This one was restored in Britain and they did a marvelous job on it, complete with the original battery cover. Just an excellent restoration and a beautiful motorcycle.
The Norton Motorcycle Company was founded by James Norton in 1898. In 1902, the Birmingham-based company began building motorcycles using French and Swiss engines. A Norton ridden by Rem Fowler in 1907 won the twin-cylinder class in the first Isle of Man TT race. That began a racing tradition that went on until the 1960s. The Isle of Man Senior TT was the most prestigious of events right from the beginning. It was won by Norton's 10 times between the World Wars and every year from 1947 to 1954. The first Norton engines were produced in 1908. This line of side valve single cylinder engines continued with few changes until the late 1950s. In 1913, the business declined. R.J. Shelley and Company, the main creditors, intervened and saved it. Norton Motors Limited was formed shortly afterwards under the joint directorship of James Norton and Bob Shelley. Norton died in 1925, aged only 56, but he saw his motorcycles win the senior and the sidecar TTs in 1924. The Camshaft 1, or CS1, engine was designed by Walter Moore and appeared in 1927. It was based closely on the ES2, a pushrod engine, and used many of its parts. On Moore's departure to the German NSU company, an entirely new overhead cam engine was designed by Arthur Carroll. It became the basis for all later overhead cam and dual overhead cam Norton single-cylinder engines. That decade spawned the Norton racing legend. Of the 9 Isle of Man TTs between 1931 and 1939, Norton won 7. Up to 1934, Norton bought the excellent Sturmey Archer gearboxes and clutches. When Sturmey decided to discontinue production, Norton bought the design rights and had them made by Berman, a manufacturer of proprietary gearboxes. Norton's also appealed to the ordinary motorcyclists because of the performance and reliability offered by their single-cylinder engines with separate gearboxes. The marque withdrew teams from racing in 1938. Between 1937 and 1945, nearly one quarter of all British military motorcycles were Norton's. In 1992, after 94 years of producing motorcycles, Norton declared bankruptcy.